Don't forget, our doctors are taking your medical questions. Email them to greatdayhouston@khou.com. When Alicia Music was 14 years old, she discovered she had a condition called PCOS, or Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome. Fertility problems can be among the symptoms. So please welcome back Dr. Michael Allon and Dr. Stephen Krotz from the Advanced Fertility Center of Texas to tell us how modern medicine can get around that problem. And, of course, our pregnant Alicia is back with us as well. All right, PCOS is one of those things that oftentimes is misdiagnosed, but let me first ask you, when did you first notice you were having any kind of issues? You didn't know what it was, but what were the symptoms early on?
I started with boy acne and facial hair at the age of 14.
Which with the acne, a lot of people would think she's a teenager.
Yeah, a teenager, no big deal. But the facial hair added to that, and I hadn't had a cycle in 2 years. Yeah. And my mom just knew that there was something not quite right. And so she took me to the doctor, and I walked in, and the doctor at that time looked at me and said, I know exactly what you have just by looking at me. Mm. So it was interesting to see that. And then she found the cysts on the ovaries and all of
right,
that kind of
right.
thing.
Right, right. Of course, when they say PCOS, it's like, well, what is that? What is PCOS?
Well, PCOS is a constellation of symptoms that affects actually 10% of women. And many women do not know they have it. But basically, PCOS is irregular menstrual cycles. It can be hair growth on the face. It's insensitivity to insulin. Those are the three main things that women see and can affect your fertility and many other cause many other health conditions.
Yeah. So in the irregular cycles, is that where the infertility comes in, or is there something else that's happening as well?
Yes, it's definitely linked to irregular cycles. Sometimes they have less than 8 cycles a year, but oftentimes 30% of women who have polycystic ovarian syndrome can have regular cycles, except they're not ovulating.
Okay.
And so it's very difficult, because women think, well, if I'm cycling regularly, I'm ovulating.
Yeah. For 7 years, you tried to get pregnant.
Yes.
And you didn't know just what to do, where to go. Of course, you probably knew what to do. It just wasn't working.
Right, it wasn't working.
Yeah, it wasn't working. And there's a frustration there, because oftentimes people will just tell you, doctors will just tell you, well, just keep trying, just keep trying.
Right.
How did you come to the decision that you did that got you pregnant now?
We actually started trying with different doctors in the different towns we lived in. And nothing was happening. I knew from the time I was 14, of course, that I was going to have issues.
Right.
But we moved to Houston, and we truly believe God brought us here for multiple reasons, for my husband's job and for my job. But we truly believe that he brought us here to meet Dr. Allon and my doctor, my OBGYN, Dr. Holt, because they knew what PCOS was,
right,
and they knew how to treat it, and they knew I was going to need some
extra help?
Extra help.
Yeah, okay.
Lots of extra help.
So what
I was
is
a
that
challenge.
Extra help? What does that extra help consist of?
Well, the difficult situation is that we know that what we call insulin resistance is linked to this phenomenon. And what happened is when women eat carbohydrates, they produce excess amount of insulin. And that excess amount of insulin causes an extra male hormone, and that causes them not to ovulate. So it's very essential to use medication as well as nutrition and lifestyle modification to lower insulin. And when you lower insulin, you can lower the male hormone, and then it becomes easier for us to get them to ovulate.
Yeah, and that's why after so long it's important to go to a specialist, because a lot of us think maybe it's just a blockage, but there are so many things that play a role, your hormone levels, thyroid levels, all kinds of levels that can really impact this. Mm-hmm. So to get her pregnant, you dealt with trying to get the insulin stabilized,
right,
and what else?
So there are several medications for patients that both want to get pregnant. Those that don't, we often give a medication called metformin, and metformin sensitizes the body to insulin, so it actually helps lower the insulin levels. And then for patients that don't want to get pregnant, we give them oral contraceptive pills, because that lowers the amount of testosterone in the body. But those that do, we often start out with a medication called clomiphene, and that's a pill that you take for 5 days at the beginning of your cycle, and that helps you ovulate and overcome the high testosterone levels.
Yeah. Did you think that it was going to work?
Yes, we really did. At the very beginning, we really thought it would work.
So you hadn't given up.
I hadn't given up, and I don't think we ever did. I think it's a journey of faith. It's trust in the doctors. It's trust that God's going to work through them and use them in your life and have a miracle come about. So.
Yeah. So PCOS is one issue that women can deal with, but when it comes to fertility issues overall, are there more women having fertility problems, or we just hear more about it today?
Well, more women are delaying their childbearing years. They're going through careers, and they think that it's not a proper time for them to spend raising a family, and because of that, more and more women are delaying it, and so it gets much, much harder to get pregnant after 37.
Yeah.
But then you have IVF and all types of other things that can help that.
One common myth, too, is that a lot of women think that because they took birth control that that actually made them infertile, but it's really the delay in childbearing, like Dr. Allon mentioned, that that is the biggest issue nowadays. Yeah.
So if you're like 62 walking and going, I think I'm ready now. but the interesting
a little
thing,
bit late.
Yeah, a little bit late. A little bit late for your own eggs, but might not be a little bit late if you still want to carry, correct?
Right. So as we discussed before, you know, fertility starts to decline around the age of 35. And then for a lot of patients, it will be difficult to get pregnant on their own after 44. But there are always the option of using egg donors. And then you can get pregnant up to the age of 50, but that's you wouldn't want to consider getting pregnant later than that because of health risks. And then the other issue too is that you know, there becomes a certain age at which you you want the parent to be around to actually take care of the child.
Yes.
And so
yeah,
that's why you wouldn't want to delay it any further than 50
yeah,
in general.
All right, so do you know what you're having?
A little girl.
Oh, good.
Yes.
Well, congratulations
thank
to you.
You.
For more about PCOS and other fertility issues, you can go to infertilityanswers.com, infertilityanswers.com. Mm-hmm. You can also call the Advanced Fertility Center at 713-467-4488. That's 713-467-4488. And if you call today and mention you saw them on Great Day, you'll receive a free consultation. Up next, how much do you know about sleep? We'll put some audience members to the test. Tonight.